Of all the things you don't want to come across when exploring an abandoned building, a shark is one of them.
A shark?
In a formaldehyde tank was found at Wildlife Wonderland in Victoria, Australia, which had been left abandoned since 2012. Urban explorer Luke McPherson visited the shuttered zoo and uploaded a 28-minute video of his adventure to YouTube in February 2019. The video attracted 14 million views, and the story of the great white shark went viral. It seems that the zoo had been closed due to offenses against wildlife.
Sounds like it. My goodness, does that ever look offensive towards wildlife? What a nasty disaster of a place. It looks like they just took almost like some Tiger King style stuff there, except instead of tigers, they had marine life, I guess. How do you get a whole tank full of formaldehyde and then throw a shark in there? What are the fumes like in that room? My goodness. And then they just left it. Like, they left all this formaldehyde in an abandoned place. Like, they didn't get rid of it. They didn't do anything to prevent people from just, like, having unfettered access to this gigantic thing of formaldehyde. Whoever was running this place was a lunatic. Maybe not evil, but definitely irresponsible. Actually, I mean, like, if you're irresponsible enough, you probably err on the side of evil anyway. Especially when you treat a shark like that. You keep a shark in a big tank full of formaldehyde? It probably wasn't always in a formaldehyde.
Guy was killed during the conflict between the Greeks and Turks in 1974, a conflict that displaced at least 200,000 people. His body was apparently taken into a cave to be disposed of. Because this guy had eaten a fig previously to being murdered, it started to grow in his stomach after he died using the scant bit of light coming into the cave. Then, the tree was found in 2011 by a researcher who was curious about how it had ended up inside of a cave. He was especially curious because there were no other fig trees in the area. When the researcher went to investigate, he was very surprised to find a human body underneath the tree, tangled in with its roots.
Wow. Honestly, that's the way I want to go. I want to be filled with some sort of plant matter and left to grow in a cave. I think that would be the ultimate burial. That's pretty sweet. Honestly, like, you know, it's tragic, very tragic what happened, that he died, but in order, like, to bring on new life, it needs to be death at some point. Actually, should I be saying that because this is the result of, like, a military conflict and people being removed from their homes? Maybe we shouldn't talk about the cycle of life and death in that way. To have a fig tree grow from within with just a little bit of cave light, that is phenomenal. Be kind of scary to find that skull, but the knowledge that something can grow from within a human like that. Hello everybody and welcome back to Top 10 Central Dark, your place for all things horror. I'm your host Keegan Hughes, and these are the top 10 scary discoveries made in unexpected places. So far, pretty unexpected. Pretty good discoveries too. Let's see what else is in store.
They had linked giant craters found in the Barents Sea to the Bermuda Triangle. The Bermuda Triangle is said to be the most dangerous area of water in the world. Thousands of planes, ships, and boats have gone missing in the area. Over the years, there have been many theories about the Bermuda Triangle, but really, no one knows exactly why everything that goes near it goes missing. But these Norwegian scientists have a pretty good idea. They said the giant craters in the Barents Sea could have been created by exploding natural gas. They also say this has the possibility of being dangerous for vehicles in the area. The exploding gas could cause massive waves, which could tip over ships. And the waves could even go as high as aeroplanes, knocking them out of the sky.
Wow, that is not something that I've ever heard about the Bermuda Triangle, but you know what, if the scientists say it's true, then that's pretty terrifying. That just random natural gas explosions cause enough turbulence to take down even airplanes? Airplanes? How high would you have to send that wave, and how is nobody else noticing this happening? That's insane. Wow. I mean, stay away from the Bermuda Triangle is the general lesson, I think, that anybody should take away from any information about the Bermuda Triangle. It's not safe. It really isn't. I've heard of, like, electromagnetic waves make engines fail and navigation difficult. I've heard, you know, it's haunted by something, but natural gas explosions intense enough to sink both ships and airplanes. Now that's wicked.
This comes from a report in the American Journal of Modern Physics. In 2016, they made a startling find. They were using a newly developed telescope for the first time, and when using it, they discovered some extraterrestrial entities in the environment. These pink dotted lights were invisible to the human eye, but the Galileo telescope with a convex lens was able to see it. The entities were said to be moving intelligently. This suggests some kind of surveillance of the area. The lights were seen at night over Tampa Bay, Florida. The scientist behind this, Dr. Santilli, found the first known evidence of an apparent existence in our universe.
Why are we not talking about this more? I feel like if we're being surveyed by aliens over Tampa, we should encourage them to go anywhere else and survey us somewhere else. Because we don't know what's going on in Florida, man. The too many Florida men running around making headlines. Holy smokes. Yeah, but like where have I been? Why did I not know about this that we possibly found evidence of alien life?
The Nazca Lines are one of the biggest mysteries in the world. They're located in Peru, and they were first spotted by commercial aircraft in the 1920s and 30s. Now with modern satellite imagery, we can get an even better picture of these lines. As you can see, there are hundreds of enormous lines. The geometric lines make depictions of animals, plants, and figures. And they were made over 2,000 years ago by people of pre-Inca Nazca culture.
That's wild that they had the foresight, the planning to be able to like create something that huge, and also like do it when they couldn't necessarily like take it in all of its glory. Like I'm sure they had some way to appreciate it, but like not to the level of airplanes or satellites, right? That's crazy. I feel like, yeah, a lot of people like look back to ancient societies and like, oh, they were so primitive, but they like lived like a totally different lifestyle, right? Like they wouldn't fit in now, of course, but they had all sorts of different kinds of like technology and things to do that made life very interesting. Yeah, wild.
2019, a 1930 era building was demolished in the Ukrainian village of Choritsa. As the building was torn down, contractors realized it had been built on hundreds of gravestones. The Soviets had seemingly tried to destroy all signs of the village's previous inhabitants and constructed a building on their graves. The discovery was made nearly 100 years later, and the tombs were traced back to a Mennonite community with ancestors in Manitoba, Canada.
Wow, that is there's a lot of history there. They've really spread out across all sorts. So we were in the Ukraine. We had Soviets in the Ukraine covering up this gravesite. Then we had the fact that they were actually a Mennonite community in the Ukraine, but they had come from Manitoba. Either that or they had people move to Manitoba and they were the ancestors and this guy is saying things backwards. But either way, there's a lot going on there. That is a bit of like a crazy discovery, right? Imagine finding that like somebody just like builds over all of the history of whatever your people are. That would be terrifying, right? It'd be tragic. But thankfully they did dig it up eventually and found some very interesting history.
While a man was searching for rocks on a beach in Michigan in 2018, he stumbled upon a mind-blowing discovery. Sitting among the thousands of ordinary pebbles on the shore of Lake Superior, the guy found a glowing rock. According to a report from CBS News, this guy found what is known as euperlite. And it's a rock that glows in such a way as to make it look like a fluorescent orb, or there is lava glowing through the cracks in the rock. It almost looks like something you would expect to find on an alien planet.
Wow, that's pretty neat. I thought it was gonna be something like a piece of radioactive material, and the guy touched it and experienced a lot of radiation. Didn't bring his Geiger counter that day. Ooh, oh, they're very pretty. Look at them glowing. It's like if you put some light through a piece of amber or something. That's really neat. Yeah, it does look like lava. I'd be afraid to touch that, let's be real.
...of bread expecting to find a pair of glasses in it, but that's exactly what happened back in 2016 when an unsuspecting customer purchased a loaf of bread, went home, and found the baker's glasses baked into it. I'm not even sure what to categorize this under. It's ridiculous, goofy, and definitely unexpected. The photo was originally posted online by a Reddit user, and since then, it has gone viral. However, the baker has yet to come forward claiming responsibility for this bread mishap.
Where's the photo? I want to see the photo. I want to see the glasses in this bread. I wonder if they like actually like cut them in half, got a nice cross section of the bread, nice and steamy coming out, and then there's like a little arm poking out. Maybe you got the actual lens in there. Yeah, I mean, that wouldn't be very tasty to eat a pair of glasses. I don't know if anybody has tried that. If you have eaten a pair of glasses, let me know how you did it, why you did it.
In 1987, some archaeologists were doing an expedition of a cave. The cave was Mount Owen in New Zealand. But as they were exploring, they found something very scary. They found a gigantic, dinosaur-like foot. It was still very much intact, with scaly skin and flesh. It was so well preserved that the scientists thought the animal must have passed away recently. But upon further examination, it was revealed to be 3,300 years old.
Holy smokes. That thing was gnarly. That's like mummified. Are we sure they didn't come off of like some sort of like mummified humanoid creature? That's bonkers that it was so well preserved. What do you think it was reaching for? Just the foot, too, eh? This feels like something off of Superstore. Anybody, any Superstore fans out there? Know about the feet? Just finding feet, It's a bird foot, though. Looks very dino-esque. That's wild.
If you've never seen a pink grasshopper, you're not the only one. These things are super rare. Pink grasshoppers only exist because of a genetic mutation caused by a recessive gene. It's very similar to how albino animals are created, at least according to National Geographic. As hard as these grasshoppers are to find in the wild, a resident in Austin, Texas took a photo of one recently after randomly spotting it in her garden. It's a totally unexpected find and something that is probably not going to happen twice to the same person. These critters exist in nature, but they very rarely grow to adulthood because predators pick them off super easily.
Wouldn't that kind of coloration, like, maybe, you know, make predators not want to eat them? You know, isn't that how, like, a lot of that stuff works? I'm no biologist. I don't know too much about recessive genes and survivability of animals in the wild, but, like, I feel like pink isn't a great color to be for something tasty in the wild, right? Wouldn't you see that and think, poison. And that's all the time we have for today, folks. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you stick around for some bloopers, because I am always saying weird stuff. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. All right. Scary discoveries made in unexpected places. Woo! Number 6. 3, 2. Actually, I'm gonna yawn. 1. It's lagging. Hold on. I'm gonna start that again. Hopefully? I don't know. Are we ready to contend with the existence of extraterrestrial life potentially looking down upon us and being unobservable to the naked human eye? Is everyone gonna have to get a Galileo telescope to walk around with in case we run into something like this that tries to steal our brains out through our butts? I don't know. You tell me. Am I missing something here?